Good day, everyone. I am Sir Jerickson Chua, and welcome to Animation One.
Animation is a method in which figures are manipulated to appear as moving images. In the traditional animation, images are drawn or painted by hand on transparent celluloid sheets to be photographed and exhibited on film. Today, most animations are made with computer-generated imagery or CGI. As ICT student, what do you think is the importance of animation? For today's lesson, I'm going to discuss to you the introduction to animation. And for our quote of the day, choose the job you love and you will never have to work a day in your life. This is according to Confucius. Because if you are passionate about what you are doing, it will be an ease for you to work hard and enjoy your work. Our learning objectives. At the end of the lesson, you should be able to discuss the relevance of the course, explain the core competency in animation, and explore job opportunities in animation. So here are the key terms that we need to be aware of in the introduction to Animation 1. Film strip, phenakistoscope, raxinoscope, katsudo shashin, handwritten images, computer-generated imagery, integration of animation, the principles of animation, cinematography, and animator. According to Matt Elias in April 2019, animation is the capturing of sequential static images or drawings or photos of inanimate objects. And by playing them in rapid succession, it mimics a real-world motion. A good example of this is on Flickbook. So as you can see here on the GIF, this is an example of a flipbook, and through these hand-drawn images, it creates a movement and creates an animation. In the digital era, animation can do more than just entertain children, because nowadays, the viewers are also adults. It's an effective tool for visual communication. That's why some of the business owners use animation as a medium in creating their advertisements. This also offers a whole new medium for expression and creativity, and it attracts more attention than static images. Animation, as we know, it was only made possible by the invention of the film strip. So the film strip is used in the cameras before. So this is used to capture photos, and it needs to be developed to see the output. But through optics, that is behind the animation and has been known since the 1800s, as we see from the Simon von Stamper's phenakistoscope in 1833, it helps us to understand fully how do animations work. So as you can see here in the GIF, these are just static drawn images, but using the invention of Simon von Stamper, okay, by moving this kind of film strip, it creates an illusion of movement. That's why this is the basis of our animation. So one of the first animation on the film was actually hand-painted by the French artist named Charles-Emile Reynaud in his praxinoscope. So this is the innovation from phenakistoscope to praxinoscope. So this is one of the stepping stone inventions that led to the film camera. Okay, so this is their basis on how they made this kind of animation before. Okay, this was in the late 1800s. In the 1900s, artists from all over the world experimented with animation, such as the recently discovered katsudo shashin, which dated from 1907 to 1911, and said to predate much of the Western animation. So this is katsudo shashin made in Japan, and this is also known as Matsumoto fragment. So this is similar with the flipbook that we have discussed a while ago. In the 1920s, animation was thought of mostly as a novelty, until the era of Walt Disney, when sound was implemented in movies. And Disney's flagship program or cartoon was named Steamboat Willie, which is made in 1928, this one. So this flagship cartoon can be seen on several Disney films as their introduction video. And it was not the first cartoon with sound, but it was one of the most popular at that time. By the 1930s, other studios caught on and there was money to be made through animation. So because of that, the impetus behind Warner Brothers launching Looney Tunes and Merry Melodies was made. Okay, so this is Merry Melodies. I guess they have several cartoons. Actually, when I was growing up, these are the cartoons that I watch. So Looney Tunes, we have here the following characters. We have Sylvester, we have Roadrunner, Daffy Duck, Coyote, we have Bugs Bunny, the Martian, we have Tasmanian Devil, and Tweety. In the 1930s, it was termed as the American Golden Age of Animation because they saw a friendly rivalry between Mickey Mouse and Bugs Bunny. And it culminated with a Disney's power play, which is the Snow White. So this is the first princess film that Walt Disney has created. And it is the first ever feature-length film to be made entirely of hand-drawn images. Okay, so it took them how many months to create this Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs? In the late 1950s, the rest is history. With the popularization of color TV, in the Hanna-Barbera, it entered into the scene. So we have here the following cartoons made by Hanna-Barbera. We have the Flintstones, Scooby-Doo, the Jetsons, and the Yogi Bear Show. In the 1960s, the Cultural Revolution, which is famously known as an X-rated cartoon, was made in 1972 and it was named Fritz the Cat. Finally, in the 1990s, CGI was created, or computer-generated imagery, and it was able to compete with the hand-drawn animation. It was popularized by the first completely CGI film, which is The Toy Story, in 1995. While CGI is used in almost every movie today, even completely animated features can now appeal to adults. Just look at the popular animated sitcoms like The Simpsons, The Family Guy, or South Park. So, The Simpsons is created by James L. Brooks, Matt Groening, and Sam Simon. It was created in December 17, 1989. And it has a running time of about 21 to 24 minutes. It has about 33 seasons and 706 episodes. So this is one of the longest sitcoms that is watched until today. The Family Guy has about 19 seasons, episodes 369. It was created in 1999 by Seth MacFarlane. And South Park has 23 seasons, 309 episodes. It was created in 1997 by Trey Parker and Matt Stone. In the recent years, the Philippines has been the subject of attention of many well-known international animation studios. This is not to say that we are a new player in animation industry. Animation in the Philippines has been around since 1950s through animated advertisement until 1979. A 60-minute animation feature was produced based on local folklore called The Adventures of Lam-ang. In 1983, the Burbank Studios of Australia was the first to subcontract animation production in the Philippines, setting up its studio in Manila. The prospects and potentials of Filipino animators have been established since then. Nowadays, more than ever, with the help of technology, animation has never been more promising to our Filipino animators. The rise and expansion of the PBO industry has been a significant factor in the demand for animation professionals in our country. But what does it really take to succeed as an animator, whether you decide to work for a company or start a company of your own? So where do we integrate animation? So we can use this as an explainer video. So modern businesses use this as a means to advertise their product. And some also use this as an instructional video, such as on the use of Powtoon to explain some concepts and ideas. Okay. Next, we can use this for loading images for websites. So it has a way to mitigate the damage of loading times. They also provide the opportunity to show off your brand personality. So using loading pages, okay, we can advertise more our product. Transitions is also used as a means of applying animation through swipes, wipes, gradient fade, shrinking, and so on. So it has a way to create the biology of the human eye to make visual changes as seamless as possible. Next is micro interaction. So this is implemented on our phones. It helps us to create motion graphics to have plenty of user experience benefits. So UX stands for user experience, in which when we create some icons on our application, it creates some good graphics in opening the app, in closing the app, okay, and using the different features of the app, and so on. We can also use this as social media videos, in which the heart of animation is to entertain and to tell a story. It helps small brands get noticed and help big brands to stand out, and their followers' feeds will be updated. Yes, we can also use it as an advertisement. So it helps us to get the attention of our potential customers through animation. Okay, especially using what we call a banner ad. So this is an example of the banner ad, which helps us magnetize, okay, our possible customers and counteract, okay, with what we call a banner blindness. Because sometimes when we create banners that are static, okay, so it doesn't catch the attention of the viewers. Animated logos, especially for website brands, okay, so while orthodox advertising dictates never change your logo, today's branding experts say animation is the exception to the rule, because using this animated logos, okay, it provides us good interaction with your viewers. Okay, so what are the core competencies of animation? Okay, so the first one is what we call the principles of animation. So we have about 12 principles of animation that we will be discussing later on our next lessons. And this refers to the skills, the processes, the techniques, the styles in creating animation materials. Okay, such as the first one is your drawing skill. So as future animators, we need to enhance and refine your drawing skills, because we will be creating some characters, backgrounds, and scenes, and other materials or objects in the animation. Okay? Next is composing through computer graphics. So as I have presented in our setting of standards, one of the applications that we're going to use is Macromedia Flash. So that's an example of computer graphics in which you will be creating your drawings using that app. And Wix Editor is also an application that we can use through website. Okay? Coloring is also important. We need to understand the psychology of colors. Okay? And it helps us to create a theme or a set of mood in our cartoon drawings and future animations. Storyboarding. Okay? So this is the blueprint of your animation. Without the storyboard, it will be a jaggery or not good animation, because you don't have a plan on how you will create your animation. So storyboarding helps us to outline and plan the direction of the story and the scenes of all the animation materials. It also provides us the character, the mood, the setting, and the scenarios of your final output. The use of technology as a tool to produce an animation material efficiently will also be discussed. And it helps us to create animation effects and special effects. So since we will be using two-dimensional animation and not three-dimensional, okay, so we will be creating some simple effects that will catch our viewers' attention. Documentation of materials is also one of the competencies that we need to understand, because we need to file our materials that will be needed in animation. The second core competency that we need to understand is the principles of cinematography, of filmmaking. Okay, so I know that you are an avid fan of some movies, okay, and some of animation cartoons. So we need to understand how cinematography works. So this refers to the skills, the processes and techniques in creating motion pictures or movies, such as the first one, an understanding of staging and blocking of characters. So we have to see that when we create our two-dimensional characters and objects, we need to have good blocking and staging. So this also includes the lighting and angles, because light is an important factor in creating some shadows and lighting on our animation. And we also need to have an understanding of the possible character performance, how they smile, how they smirk, how they get shocked, okay? How the hand moves, how the hair moves, and all of the components of the character that needs to be performed. Okay, so let's now proceed to the job opportunities in animation. So, as I said, on one of our objectives, we need to explore the different job opportunities in animation. So here are some of it. Okay, so later on, when you will be graduating in college and you will going to pursue in animation, here are some of the jobs that you might look into. The first one is a 3D modeler. So you can do 3D characters and environments that is based on the concept art. So there are a lot of 3D movies using what we call CGI. So one good example of it is yung Monster Incorporated. Okay, and so on. Flash Animator, since we will be using our Macromedia Flash, you can do some websites, simple videos, advertising and marketing, and even games, by the way. So we can create games using our Flash Animator. And you can also do stop motion animation. So as this is similar with creating some flip books, okay, using different models, puppets or clay to create animated films. You can also do this for television commercials and branded entertainment. So you can also create some video game designers if you're going to pursue 3D animation. Okay? So this uses technology, science, engineering, mathematics, design, art, animation to create video games for a variety of consoles. And I hope you are, and I know that you are very fond of using your phone as a means to play games, so you can also do that. Okay, cartoonists are able to draw advertising, political, social, and sports cartoon, and forensic animator is also one of a good job opportunity for you, because you can just create recreate crime scenes and accident to help the investigators solve a crime. So these are some of the job opportunities in animation that we should be aware of. In summary, animation is a method of photographing successive drawings, models, or even puppets to create an illusion of movement in a sequence. Animation is important because it makes us able to tell stories and communicate emotions and ideas in a unique way, easy to perceive way that both small children and adults can understand. And for future animator, one must possess the different skills and competencies in animation. For our first activity, you need to answer our research work. So you need to research some job opportunities for animation here in the province or in the Philippines, and you need to list at least 5 jobs with short description. After that, you need to look for 3 Filipino animators who made it big in the global animation industry or in the Hollywood. Write about their roots, how they started in the animation industry, how they got into the animation international scene, and what are their famous or recent work. So here we can just see how animators became famous and how they started using their animation skills. As an exit token for our first lesson, I want you to list down 3 things you understand in the lesson, 2 things you want to know more, and 1 question in mind. So just list this on any piece of paper or your notebook as our exit token of our discussion for the day.
Thank you for watching, and I hope that you have learned many things from our discussion. See you on our next lesson. Keep safe, and God bless.